You may be seated tonight. We have something we would like to share with you.
Thank God that we are about to take a journey where every day matters. Pastor Parsley is going to be behind this desk for 4 weeks straight teaching us, watch this, the basics of life, where we're going to grow spiritually, physically, mentally. Come on, somebody shout with me. Financially, it is going to be an amazing time. So tell everybody you know, get on Facebook, tell them they need to be here next Wednesday night where God is going to speak to us. Everyone standing, everyone standing, everyone standing. It is an honor and a privilege to introduce tonight the man that's going to deliver a word from the Lord. I just had an opportunity to be in the back with him. There's a lot of stuff I can say, but I'm going to save time and I'm going to say it with this. If he wants to tell you all the things that he does and all the foundations and ministries he has, not only in America, but in Africa, if he wants to tell you he's the best-selling author of all his books, I'm going to let him do this. But I want to speak the word of the Lord to him, about him to you. Jesus said, when you pray, do it in secret. And when you do it in secret, God will reward you openly. I want you guys to know in here and those that are watching by the way of iHeart, we're going to be blessed tonight because this is a man of prayer. I want you to continue to clap your hands, make some noise, and make welcome back home, Valor Christian College graduate, Pastor Evans Kariuki.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Come on and give God the greatest shout of the day. Come on, give him a shout that ashames the devil. Give him a shout that ashames the devil. Come on, come on, Vala, lift up your voice and give God glory. Yeah, mama, 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 sheta, daba, sheta. Ah, ah, ah. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, yeah. When you lift up your voice and shout. Just tell your neighbor, when you lift up your voice and shout, you weaponize your praise. So tell them, don't be quiet, turn your worship into your warship. Lift up your voice and give God glory. Don't be silent, lift up your voice and give God glory. Yama, mama, 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 say, hallelujah, hallelujah. Weaponize your praise, weaponize your praise. Turn your every hand lifted, every hand lifted, every hand lifted. Spirit of the living God, do what only you can do. Come and move amongst us, my God. Resurrect what was dead. Touch our lives like never before. Let the fullness of your spirit be made manifest. Let the power of your glory be made real. May you cover us as the waters cover the sea. May you wear us as a glove, my God. Let the fullness of the spirit, come on. Let the fullness of the spirit of God come through now. Let gifts arise. Let callings come forth. Let the power of God be made real in your life today. Come on. Tell God this is that moment where everything changes. Tell God this is it, where everything changes. Come on. Come on and bless the Lord. Tell him this is it. This is it. How many of you think or can even attempt to think that God needs more than one moment to change your life? To answer every prayer you've ever prayed. To hear every cry you've ever cried. What makes you think he needs a lifetime to touch your life? Oh, yeah, 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 yeah. It's any moment, it's any day, any hour, any minute, and any second, and resurrection power comes into your life and everything begins to change. Lift up your voice and give God glory. Come on and worship Him. Come on and worship Him in the instruments. Come on and worship God. Create an atmosphere for Him. Jesus. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. We give you access, Jesus. Have your way amongst your people, Lord. The Bible says in the book of Revelation chapter 8 that the seventh seal was open. And when the seal was open, there was silence in the heavens. The heavens were silenced. The Bible only mentions the heavens being silenced for that one moment. And the Bible says for 30 minutes the heavens were silenced. So I went to find out why the heavens were silenced. And as you continue to read, the Bible says that the angel would take the prayer of the saints and lift them up before the Lord. The heavens were silenced for 30 minutes so God can hear your prayer. Why are you quiet? Why are you quiet? The heavens were silent so God can hear your prayer. Your silence be louder than your shout. Oh, I'm going to move my seat. We have 30 minutes to lift up our voice and cry aloud and spare none. Get your Bible, get your Bible, get your Bible, get your Bible, get your Bible. Hallelujah. I honor the angel of this house, my pastor, and the elders of this house. I honor each and every one of you, the servants and everyone who does anything in this house. I honor you. We bless the Lord for each and every one of you. Hallelujah. You have your Bible? Hallelujah. Luke chapter 7. Luke chapter 7, verse 11. Tell your neighbor 7:11. Take a seat, take a seat, take a seat. Hallelujah. 7:11. The following day, he went into a city called Nain. Someone say Nain. And many of his disciples and a large crowd went with him. When he came near the gates of the city, a man who had died was being carried out. Somebody say, a man who has died was being carried out. A man who has died was being carried out. And the Bible says, being carried out, the only son of his mother. The only son of his mother. And she was a widow. Somebody say a widow. And a large crowd from the city was with her. When the Lord saw her. Oh, yeah, yeah. How many of you are glad to know that you could be amongst the crowd, but God will see you? You could be one amongst the crowd, but he only has an audience of one. Somebody just say, Lord, come and see about me. Come and see about my situation. The Bible says, and he saw her. He had compassion on her and said to her, do not weep. Then he came and touched the coffin, and those who carried it stood. He said, young man, I say to you, arise. I want us to read verse 15 together. 1, 2, 3, go. And he who was dead sat up and began to speak. Today I come with a message from the throne room of God to let you know that Jesus never did a funeral and he will never begin with you. Jesus never did a funeral and he's not going to begin with you. I don't know if you have some things in your life that you need to be resurrected, but my Bible says Jesus, he attended many funerals, but he never did a funeral and he will not begin begin with you. The devil has been lying to you that your career is over, that your destiny is over, that your calling is over. I come with the anointing of the Holy Spirit to let you know that the Son of the Living God, He never did a funeral, and He will not begin with you. Why aren't you shouting? Are you still saved? Yeah. Shout until it's not you shouting. Shout until it's the Holy Spirit in you. Say, Jesus, He never did a funeral, and I won't be His first, and I will not be His faster. Your business will not be the first one. Your family, it will not be the first one. Your calling, my brother, your calling, my sister, will not be the first one that Jesus buries. The Bible says that Jesus Christ, it tells us He attended funerals, but my God, He changed the situation. He never did a funeral, and He won't begin with a shout unto God. Take a seat, take a seat, take a seat. Give me the fourth slide. Give me the fourth slide. It was in April 2015. It was in April 2015. My team and I were in Nairobi, Kenya. We had started a mission work in the slums. And one night at 3 a.m., I'm going to reduce the story short, but at 3 a.m., I got a phone call. And the phone call was disturbing. The person said there was a shooting. I said, a shooting, what happened? They said there was a shooting and so has been shot 7 times. I said, where is he? He said, he's been taken to the mortuary, 3 a.m. I said, let me call you back. Let me call you back. 4 a.m., I picked up my phone and called them back. I said, which mortuary? And they said, it's either the city mortuary or the university's mortuary. And we said, let's go. I gathered a team of mine of young teenagers, a few young men and women, and we went down to this mortuary. We got a document that allows us to see the body, and the young man that was there is a man who I had started discipling to and ministering the gospel to. And I told them, I want my brother's body. Give it to me. Give it to me. Take him out. Take him out. I showed them the paperwork. I told them, give me the body. Give me a room. And I was so angry in my spirit that the devil can come in the middle of the night and snatch away a life, and the fire of the Almighty God resurrected in me. Let me tell you this, for the sake of time, this young man, we began to pray. We were 12, we were 8 in the room. We began to pray. And we began to pray. 30 minutes passed. We began to pray. 45 minutes passed. And right at the 47th minute point, when everyone was getting tired, the people in the room had started saying, this is crazy. This is madness. And something very peculiar happened. We were praying, and I started smacking him with my breakthrough Bible. I don't know if you can see that. I just started smacking him. Life. Started smacking him. Life. Started smacking him life, started smacking him life, and something began to, yeah. I don't know if you believe the word of God today, that Jesus never did a funeral, and He will not begin with you. Started smacking him, smacking him, smacking him as we were praying, and right after I slowed down with the smacks, his hand did one of these. That was it. His hand did one of these. His fingers began to move. It was now about 8 a.m. in the morning. His fingers began to move. I went to feel his legs, and his legs began to warm up. But let me tell you, I learned my greatest lesson that day, because the moment he began to move, the people who had been praying with me for almost an hour, they ran out of the room. My God, you better be careful who you go to pray with. You better be careful who you go to pray with. You better be careful who's in prayer with you. Yeah, mama. Not everybody that's with you is for you, and they don't believe like you. Shout unto God until it's not you shouting. The Bible says in the book of Luke chapter 7, the Bible says that the woman, the widow of Nain, she had people all around her. How do you know that that sometimes in the situations of life, you could be around many people, but they cannot help you. They cannot offer you any help. They cannot assist you. Yeah, mama, she was surrounded with people. Oh, Jesus never did a funeral. Yeah, mama. The Bible says in Luke chapter 7, there were two crowds on the outside of the door of the gates. Outside the gates, there were two crowds. One was the crowd of Jesus. Somebody said, that's me. I'm in that crowd. On the other end, coming out of the gate, was the widow of Nain. Let's look at this widow. Let's look at her life. The Bible says, you need to sit down. You need to sit down. We said 30 minutes. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the widow of Nain, on one end, she's carrying her dead son. And the Bible just doesn't say her dead son. It says her only son. Her only son. I don't know if you found yourself in a situation in life where you come from bad to worse. I'm a widow. My husband is dead. I've walked this journey before. I've been down this road before. I have made the funeral arrangements before. But this time, my brother and sister, Jesus is about to interrupt your journey. Jesus is about to interrupt your journey. Because Jesus never did a funeral. And he will not begin with you. Shout unto God. Come on and give God glory in this house. Yeah, mama. Is there faith in the house of God? Is there faith in the house of God? The widow of Nain, she finds herself, her husband is dead. But you say, you know me, my husband is not dead, but you have a dead marriage. The husband doesn't pray in the home. The husband doesn't even come at home at night. You're raising the kids on your own. They call you the baby mama. He gave you the kids and ran away. He might as well be good as dead. Some of the, I hear in America, we call them deadbeat dads. Mama. Maybe that's where you find yourself. Mama, you're raising a child on your own. You're raising a family on your own. Today I come to tell you, for your children, it's not over. Jesus never did a funeral, and he won't begin with yours. For your relationships, it's not over. You're not going to be single forever. Why aren't you shouting? Are you still saved? The devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. And the author of all lies. The husband was dead. The husband was gone. The husband was dead and buried. And now she's carrying her son. Her only son. Do you know what that means to her? That life is over. I don't know if you've ever lost someone. Everyone around you cannot feel your pain. They cannot understand your anguish. They cannot understand the torment, the memories that you have in your mind, in your heart, the tears that you cry at night. They cannot understand it. So it was with a widow. Many people around her, but they did not know. They couldn't understand what she was going through. The widow of Nain. And the Bible says that she, on that journey, she sees a group of people coming her way. And she says, why are they so happy? Why are they shouting? Why are they dancing? Have you ever walked into the church and wondered, why is he spinning so much? What does he know that I don't know? Why is his life so much better than mine? Does he serve a different God than I do? My God, the Spirit of the Lord is in this place. If you don't feel him, check your salvation. I feel God in this place. Why are they shouting so much? Why are they so excited? I'm in the same building, but I don't feel the same way. We are walking the same path, but I don't feel the same. We are in the same area, but I don't feel the same. There was a crowd going to meet her, and out in the middle was the Son of the Living God We'll get there shortly. But the Bible says that they were carrying the casket of her boy. Every step is a memory. She remembers how he was playing in the dusty roads. Every step is a memory. She remembered how he's the one who strengthened her when her husband died. And now let's take a look at the young man, because that's where some of you find yourself. You find yourself dead in your Christian life. Your life is wrapped up in the dead grip of sin. Your life is wrapped up in sin. You're trying to live right for God, but there is something that keeps you in that coffin. You're trying to do the right thing, but there is something that keeps you in that coffin. I want to tell you today, the people may have counted your calling out. They may have said it's over. They may have said your time is run out, but Jesus never did a funeral, and it won't begin with you. Can I preach the word of God? 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 The church has become so judgmental. We've forgotten about the mercy of God. The moment we reach a place, we think that we got there by ourselves, in and of ourselves. How many of you know my Bible says, for all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God? Yeah. The one thing we have in common is the death grip of sin. Yeah. But you find yourself there. Vala students, your mother is praying for you, looking over you. How many of you know when you touch a dead body, it's cold? When you touch a dead body, it's lifeless. Maybe that's how your prayer life has been the last couple of days. Today, everything changes. The days of dead, prayerless lives is over in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The young man dead in a casket. The young man wrapped up in his embalmment clothing. The young man, his time has been counted out. They said it's over. You'll never open a business again. Your credit is too bad. The devil is a liar and so are they. The devil is a liar and so are they. The devil is a liar and so are they. So you lost the house, let it go. So you lost the car, let it go. Today is a new day. Resurrection power is coming into your home. It's coming into your life. Tell your neighbor, Jesus never did a funeral, and you won't be the first. He won't begin with you. The young man, he's been carried. And maybe that's how some of you have been. Let me find myself a young man. Let me find one. Maybe that's how some of you have been. Come, my brother. Come. Maybe that's how you've been. Your mother is dragging you to church every day. Mamas, come on and give God praise. You're bringing your children to church by force. You're bringing them to church and telling them, why don't you try go to the altar? Try and pray. Try and seek God. And you're wondering, when will my son be touched with the fire of the Holy Spirit? When will God move on my children? When will God... Come on, can we be real in the house of God? I preach to millions of young men, and I've come to realize there is a disease that is engulfing our generation, and it's an ideology of who God is. They do not know God. They do not know His voice. They think they do, but they do not know. I remember a time when I walked into this building and I heard the gospel preached, and I was so afraid for myself because of the word that was being preached. Don't go yet. Young man, come into church every day, lifeless. Come into the house of God every day, lifeless. Somebody say, 10 minutes, get ready. 10 minutes, get ready. Come into the house of God, lifeless, lifeless. Lifting up your hands, and the only thing you can think about is the sin you were committing last night. Are you going to be real in the house of God? Lifting up your hands, but the only thing that comes before you is sin. David said, my sin is ever before me. My sin is ever before me. I tried to go to his house, but the sin was ever before me. I tried to go to the house of God, but the sin was ever before me. Dead man's bones, and you're wondering, can these bones live? Can these bones live? Can these bones live? Can these bones live? Can I shout like they shout? Can I jump like they jump? Can I spin like they spin? Can I feel God like they feel Him? I want to feel Him in my body. I want to feel something that no one can take away from me. I want God to be so real to me that no one can take away from me. If that is your prayer, I want you to lift up your voice and give God glory. Baptize Him with fire in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Make it real. 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 Make it real, my God. Speak in the Holy Ghost. Speak in the Holy Ghost. The widow of Nain, her dead son. That's where you find yourself. And on the other side, Jesus walking down, and something's about to happen. Two crowds coming in, outside the gate. Somebody say outside the gate. Outside the gate. Outside the gate, coming in. Coming in, and that's where you find yourself today. That's where you find yourself today. Outside the gate. Outside the gate, why? Because the widow was going to bury her son as far away from the city as she could. And once in a while, she'll go and look at the body and look at her husband. And that's how we are in the church. We bury our sins far. We bury our sins far. We come into church, what do we call it? Sunday best. We come into church wearing Sunday best on the outside. How many of you know the sharpest you will ever be is in your casket? The sharpest suit you'll ever wear is the day they bury you and put you down in the grave. Looking sharp on the outside. Oh yeah, put back that picture. Put back that picture. Put it back. Put it back. Put back that picture. Ha! Come on and shout unto Jesus. Shout unto Jesus. Look at that. Look at that. The man has been counted out. On the side, there were four coffins. Two on this side, two on this side. Two on this side, two on this side. The suit had been selected. The burial ground had been chosen. We began to pray. As we are about to pray in this place. The doctors have counted you out, meet Jesus. They have counted you out, meet Jesus. Now watch this. The Bible says that Jesus went, and this is amazing. There was no reason, you can see it please. There was no reason why Jesus would have been in Nain. It was a small city, a place called Beautiful. That's what Nain means. Nain, depends on what side of the ocean you're from. I'm from the side that we say Nain. Hallelujah. Yeah. 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 Oh. Yeah. 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 Oh. Yeah. 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 Oh. Yeah. 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 Something's about to happen. So the Bible says that in the middle, Jesus meets her. And as he meets her, he didn't ask her about her faith. He didn't ask her, do you believe? He just says, weep not. Oh, mama, weep not. Oh, papa, weep not. Young man in Valor College wondering why you were sent here, weep not. Soon enough, you're going to find out. Tomorrow, the chapel is going to be a deliverance service, and your life will never be the same. My God, watch this. Watch this, watch this, watch this. Watch this. Jesus looks at her and says, weep not. Weep not. Do not cry. Tell your neighbor, weep not. Weep not. Mama, weep not. Your destiny of your children is safe. Ha! Then the Bible says that Jesus, after telling her weep not, he looked at this child and touched him. He touched him. And touching him, touched him. And the life of God, the life of God flowed so deep on the inside of this young man. I love Jesus. Do you love him? Do you love him? I love what he does. Do you love him? The life of God came on the inside of this young man. And the Bible says that he who was dead, he rose up and began to speak. I come to speak into the dead situation in your life. You're not just going to talk to it, you're going to speak to it. Speaking to it has an anointing. Speaking to it has an anointing. Ya mama mama mama. Ya kata baba baba sheta. Ya mama mama shekata. I feel God in this place. I feel God in this place. I feel the Holy Spirit. If you're saying there are some things in my life that I need resurrected, don't stay in your seat. Run to this altar. 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 Come on. Jesus never did a funeral and it won't begin with you. Jesus never did a funeral and you won't be the first. Ya mama mama shetata. Ya kata, every hand lifted. Every hand lifted. Every hand lifted. Every hand lifted. Somebody say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Come on, like an army. One for all for one. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, you've never done a funeral and you won't begin with these people, my God. May the resurrection power come into the finances of these young men and women. May resurrection power come into the families of these young men and women. May the fire of the Holy Spirit come and engulf their hearts. Come and engulf their souls in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Why aren't you praying? Come on and pray over your situation. Ya tata baba baba basheta. Ya mama mama. Ya katabo shete. Re katabo babo she. Ya mama mama. Resurrection power coming into your life. If you're watching online, the power of the resurrection on iHub coming into your sitting room, coming into your bedroom, coming in through your computer right now in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Give God glory. Call it by name. Call it by name. Call it by name. My marriage will not die. My calling will not die. My destiny will not die. The anointing in my life will not die. Because today it encounters Jesus. My children will not die. Call them by name. My children will not die. Call them by name. Come on and call them by name. Come on and call them by name. In the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your hands. Lift up your hands. Let me bless you. Let me bless you. Spirit of the living God. Spirit of the living God. Just one touch from you and these lives are changed. Now touch each and every young man and woman in this place, my God. Let the destinies rise up in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Come on and shout your way back to your seat and give God glory. Yeah, mama, 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 come on. Come on and shout your way back to your seat and give God glory. Wait, I hear in the spirit, this is what the woman, the widow of Nain, was singing with her son on the way back to Nain. I'm sure he wasn't carried back. They held hands on the way back. Find someone to dance with. Hold someone's hand, and we are going to dance for resurrection power. I'm alive in him. Come on, find someone to dance with. Dance with your son. Dance with someone today. This is how they were dancing on their way back to Naive. Come on.
Jumping. You know what? Hold up. We don't need no music. Jump, 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 jump.
Seriously, like, everybody just stop. Y'all keep going. Y'all keep going. I can imagine, because for them to carry him outside of the city, that probably meant there was no musicians there. And when they saw that young man stood up, everything that was dead in them became alive. I need some radical people in here for the next 2 minutes to give God a ridiculous praise that's not led by anybody. Come on, we got 2 minutes to let the devil know I'm about to sit up. I feel revival in here. Come on, you got 2 minutes to give God a ridiculous type of... Y'all ain't screaming loud enough. I can imagine that mother, when she saw her dead boy get up, she began to scream. All the ladies, scream. All the men, yeah. I'm talking about your dead dream is about to sit up. That lost family member is about to sit up. Your finances are about to sit up. My God, I heard you, God. Somebody was on divorce, but your marriage is about to sit up. I heard you, Holy Ghost. We got one more minute. Your relationship with God. No, y'all don't know when to shout. Your relationship with God. Y'all still don't know when to go crazy. Your relationship with the Holy Ghost is about to scream as loud as you can. To your seat real quick. Everybody sit down real quick. You know what time it is. It's offering time. Now watch this. I told you a testimony Sunday. Get an offering envelope. Everybody, listen, everybody. I don't care if you don't have anything. Ask your neighbor for a dollar. Y'all laughing. Some of you got pride. You know you need to put something in the ground and you don't have it. Ask your neighbor for a dollar. Here's the reason why. It was a Wednesday night. It was a Wednesday night, just like this, where the heavens opened. And God told us, everybody get a seed in the ground. If you don't have something, ask somebody for a quarter. And a woman All she had to her name was a dollar. And her and God began to have a conversation. But then she did something crazy. Imagine that. She trusted God. She sold a dollar in an atmosphere like this. Y'all just scream for 3 seconds. Scream. One, two, three. Okay. Her and God had a conversation. She sold that dollar. Couple of weeks later, I was walking right here on my way to give something to somebody. And she said, "Hey, Elder G, can I testify?" I said, "Absolutely you can." She said, "Well, you remember a couple..." She said, "You remember a couple of weeks ago? You said everybody sow a seed, and if you have a dollar, sow a dollar." She held up the offering envelope and said, "I want to show you my tithe off of a $1 seed." Her tithe check was for $400. Now, maybe some of y'all ain't smart like me in math. That's basically a $1 seed got her a $4,000 check in the mail. And I want to prophesy to somebody, when you put this seed in the ground, finances are not only going to sit up, they're about to show up. And watch this. Watch this, because I know some of y'all, come here, some of y'all think I'm lying. Who am I talking about?
Me.
Who?
Me.
And the same God that can do it for her, my God, y'all missed it. The same God that can do it for her, y'all ain't shouting loud enough. The same God that can do it for her is about to do it for you, because he's about to sit up in your life. Sit down, sit down, sit down. Everybody got at least a dollar, a quarter, a penny, something. I'm telling you, I feel like testimonies is about to overwhelm us in the local church office. I feel it. I'm telling y'all, I ain't playing. This is our time. This is our season. This is our moment. Hold that seat up in the air. We're going to try that song one more time. Hold it up in the air. Fashekotra. Come on, keep waving it. Just wave it in this atmosphere. I'm telling you, God's about to... I'm telling you that things that are dead, things that are dead, it's about to come alive again. Ha! Wave it in this atmosphere. All right, now I want you to stand up and wave. Stand up and wave. I know. Come on, 15 more seconds, 14, 13, 12, everybody get a seat. If you see somebody ain't got nothing, be a blessing. Six, come on, five, four, three, two, one. Now this is what we're gonna do. He said something so powerful. He said it so quick, I don't want you to miss it. He said there comes a moment where you talk, but then you start speaking with the anointing. He said there comes a moment when you talk, but then there comes moments when you speak with the anointing. I'm about to say the quickest prayer ever for offering. And what I want you to do, I want you to run down here, and I want you to run speaking the word of the Lord over your seat. You ready? Wave it. Father, sit up in our finances in Jesus' name. Amen. Come on, sow that seed.
You are all we need. Your love has
speak to your future.
You are all we need. Your love
speak to your future.
You are all we need. Your love
speak to your future. I was you, I would not miss Sunday morning. Because the same spirit that's in here now, I believe is gonna go a little higher than this. Tell everybody you know, revival is breaking out at World Harvest Church. At Harv, get ready. This is about to be the greatest season of your life. We love you